As a group, we couldn't have asked for a better tour directing, acting above and beyond our expectations. As individuals, it wasn't long before you became our friend, listening to our daily tales of adventure, sorting out our concerns or problems, never with a frown or terse voice. Don't know how you do it.
Except when I yelled at you for not bringing me a drink from the bar.
I shared it.
Thank you for everything. You've helped make our dreams come true. It's true, Lisa. You really are number one.
I hate endings. I'm not a fan of goodbyes. And my first two tours actually cried horribly. Oh my god!
There you can cry.
Stuff a few in here. 31 days is a long time to be away from home, comforts, family, friends, animals, fur babies. And I love traveling, but I'm all about family and I'm all about surrounding myself with people that I love. And so, on one hand, the adventure always calls, and I get very excited. On the other hand, the part of me that loves to be surrounded by people I care for and I trust, that's always a question mark. And I've had a few tours that have, all my tours have been great, but I've had a few tours where I haven't been able to connect as well with the people that are on tour. And for 31 days, that's a long time to be away from home and not have people to trust and love. So this tour has been absolutely amazing for me. I feel like I have sisters and uncles and a couple of almost surrogate moms and dads.
Moms and dads too.
Yeah, absolutely. And every time, even when we have those early mornings, and the first thing that happens for me, who hates early mornings, is that 11 o'clock goes up and I think, but then, after a few minutes and coffee brewing, I start to get excited for the day. And that excitement does not come anymore because I've done enough of these tours where I've experienced all the wonderful things. And yes, I'm always excited to go back. But the excitement for me comes from sharing those things with each and every one of you. And so I just want to say thank you for being who you are, for being open to this opportunity. Many of you have not had a chance to travel with other people. Some of you have and have had wonderful, amazing experiences, whether it was the itinerary, the tour director, whoever, and now you have to trust that your next situation will be good. Others have maybe had a negative experience and had to kind of just soldier on and say, let's see what happens next time. But either way, I can say for each and every one of you that it has been a wonderful pleasure getting to know you, to see smiles on your faces and hear you laugh, to hear you bitch about something that wasn't as good. You're honest, you are incredibly open and ready to sit down and hang out with anybody, which is to me a joy because sometimes as a tour director, one of the things you look at in the first week is there anyone being left out? How do I integrate them into the group? You know, what is this group like? Can I tell the jokes? Are they going to go over well? Like, just all those things. And I have found with you that although this is my job and I am working hard, it has been, in many cases, a piece of cake. And that is because of how much fun I'm having with you. And if you weren't being you, if it was a different group, that might not be the same situation. So thank you very much for an amazing tour. I have no idea. I'm Evergreen and Scenic are not happy that they're putting me on this next tour because they know I'm exhausted. And I was very much thinking, oh, I'm going to blow all my energy on this one and then I'm going to sleep for 2 weeks. That's not the case anymore. And, you know, as I mentioned to a few of you, I had a stress nightmare last night where I was like, all the people that showed up were people that I saw in high school that I didn't like because they were really sneaky and horrible. And they were all like, oh, you're our tour director?
They're coming.
And all I can say even if they are as wonderful as you are, it's not going to be the same. It's just not. I am so privileged to have had this time with you. My sister and I often have one or two conversations over the length of a tour, and we're always bragging. And it's funny because it gets a bit competitive. Oh yeah? Well, my group, we did this and this happened and these people had it. So it's pretty funny. But I was telling her some of the stories from this tour, and she just said, "Man, I wish I could be there. I wish I could see this group because they sound amazing." And on that note, before I cry, I'm going to try to sing you a song. I could instead that people throw into our lives for a reason, bringing something we must learn, and we are there to root and help us most grow if we let them. Help in return. Well, I don't know if I believe that's true. I know I'm who I am today because I knew you. Like the comet pulled from orbit as it passes the sun, like the sea dropped by the sky.
And they've stuffed us around a bit. What we're going to do is we're going to take the numbers and we're going to change them all around. So when we're gone tomorrow, man, they'll be stuffed.
Thanks, Wes.
Here we are. This is our last stop. And we're at the wonderful Westmark. Can't contain my excitement if you have a look around. Neither can anyone else. Here's the Evergreen group that are left. Evergreen.
Green with envy.
No, not really. And you can see the beautiful lounge, the lounges that they offer.
Oh, no, maybe not.
The tour desk, crowded. No, not that either. What's going on? TV.
Beautiful people on the tour.
Beautiful people. Come on. It's one of our tour people here. had a great time with me. I don't know about, I'm not going to go into that with his wife.
No, no.
But that's just between him and I, before this goes on YouTube.
And what happens in Whitehorse stays in Whitehorse. Good.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you. It was good. It was good.
Would I pass as an actor?
Yeah.
You're just being polite.
No, I'll play. And the excitement rolls. It just keeps going, doesn't it? It just keeps going here in Whitehorse. Another one of our tour.
People are so excited to be here.
Too excited.
An hour to go before we leave.
Ooh.
We're going for a coffee.
Okay. People are crowded. They're piling in now. Piling in. Only because a bus stopped. And that's usually why they pile in, because they've got to get out. Elevators are to your left. But they don't know we've changed all the room numbers around. So no one will get into their room. We'll talk to you later. It's peak hour now. Peak hour. How'd it go? Peak hour at the Westmar, Whitehorse. They don't know what to do, where to go. But they're going to be in for a real treat. I'm sure you watch out.